Cotton Fest, more than just a festival, bigger than anything our culture has ever seen. A true manifestation of what it means to be young, gifted, and free. To see and be seen. To celebrate and be celebrated. The vision of one of the greatest icons I've ever known in real life and in full Technicolor. My name is Moozlie and I'm so blessed to be bringing you insights and essence into this amazing experience. I'll be talking to industry insiders, some of the biggest artists in music, festival attendees, and giving you the full lowdown on how Riky Rick's legacy lives on. I'll be showing you how the whole game came together to celebrate a life well lived and the impact it continues to have. Because cotton eaters never die. They multiply. Manga hambi na mi, you must be against me. And manga guza, don't you get them cold feet. Hang ganga ngok ganga la, hey. I said hang ganga ngok la la la, yeah. Ma bona mi nak pela, no I'm not alone. My niggas on the low, spotted by the dress code. Hang ganga ngok ganga la, hey. I said hang ganga ngok la la la. From its inception in 2019, Cotton Fest has always been a place where all different kinds of people from all different walks of life could come together to express their common love for music, fashion, street culture, and the power of community. All things that the founder, the late great Riky Rick, held close to his heart. Over the years, through a pandemic, and even after losing its visionary, the festival has grown to be bigger and better than ever before, welcoming thousands of attendees over 2 days. A first for a festival of its kind in SA culture. Let's meet some of these cotton eaters and find out why they come to Cotton Fest.
Sherelle Swain from Washington, D.C., and I am a filmmaker at Cotton Fest today. Excited to be here. It's my first time at Cotton Fest. It's my first day in South Africa, and I was not planning to be here today, but my friend, she brought me here, and I'm happy for it.
I'm enjoying the community value, the whole, like, you know, people are coming together for the value of fashion and music. So, yeah, I'm here to rock. Let's rock.
It's my second time out at Cotton Fest today. It's lovely. The spirit is crazy.
I really like live music, so I'm just enjoying the live music, the vibe, the people, the outfits.
Getting introduced to new artists, the activations that are really dope.
So, like, events like this hardly happen in SA, especially, like, during, like, the COVID period. So, like, having an event at Cotton Fest, like, actually happening now is a great thing. We haven't been to an event like this in a minute.
I think the culture has lagged in terms of fashion, in terms of fashion unity. People still are rocking the sickest fashion outfits out there, but there's no really much of a big event like this that unites everyone who are cotton eaters basically. So with Cotton Fest, you see everything. You see people wearing creepy, people wearing strange, but when you hear, it's not strange. It's basically fashion.
No cap in his rap. Cotton Fest was built on a solid foundation of eating the cotton. For those of you who don't speak Joburg slang, that basically means being dressed to the nines and making sure you come harder than ever before, no matter what that means to you. One person who knows all about this is fashion stylist and entrepreneur Boogie Maboy. She's got years of experience styling some of your favorite artists. She's also the owner of Boogie's Bodega, and she's actually the last person that Riky allowed to personally style him. Big deal. Monumental deal, people. Huge, huge deal here with the one and only, one of the most iconic stylists in the game. And you know it's serious, because I went and fetched Riky's guy. I said, I don't want mistakes. I'm going straight to Riky's guy. So we're here with Boogie, and she's just going to take us through the outfits that I'm going to be wearing today.
First things
they're
first.
They're quite hectic.
First things first, I want to say, before I was Riky's guy, I was actually Nomuzi's stylist. I don't know why she's thrown me away. I've been styling Nomuzi since
the beginning of
her career. Album covers. I'm talking just... any special Nomuzi moment from back in the day was a Style by Boogie moment. So I've been Nomuzi stylist long before I was Riky's stylist.
Thank you.
But now she's given me away to Bozonke. So
no, I'm just trying to let people know the style level.
Or how serious
and
it is.
And then you're like, Dala, you just
like Nomuzi is Style by Boogie family. She's been with us. Like, she's trusted the vision from the very, very beginning. So it's so nice to be able to, like, come back. Like, I've been doing this 15 years and still be working with, like, the same people who just love the brand and trust what it is we do. So I had to take it to the top for my day one girl, you know? So the cool thing about this look is that Moozlie and I have actually shot this before when we were doing PR images for her back in the day. So this is one of these looks you probably haven't seen. It didn't come out, just also to show how deep the relationship is with Moozlie. So I'm bringing this back because it's never lived before. Mm-hmm. It still has the tag on it, like literally from the day that she wore it in the shoot, and it didn't kind of make the cut. So this is Fenty Puma, one of those really, really special kind of grail pieces. This is not the kind of like Fenty or Puma piece you're going to see in the street on anyone. Mm-hmm. So shout out to the girl Rihanna, we're still representing for you. We've got these ice cream jeans, super cool. Like I said, 2000s was all about like putting your logo right front of center where everybody can see it. If you're a fan of like Pharrell, then you've seen this dog print on like everything he's worn probably for the past like 15 years or so. So that's a really special piece. And you know, varsity jackets are kind of like the rage right now. Every brand is made a varsity jacket this year. So we had to take it back to the original varsity jackets. The reason your brand has a varsity jacket is because of this one. If you know me, you know that I'm obsessed with local brands. This is a milliner called Christelle Birch. She's one of the big hat brand makers in South Africa. And this is from her Jamiroquai range, which came out in 2018 or 19. So we're pulling like archival pieces for this moment. Even if you had to hit up Christelle Birch, you'll never be able to get this hat. Like,
where did you get it, Boogie?
Ish. If I tell you guys, I'm gonna have to kill you.
You guys saw the looks, they were crazy. But I wanted to know from someone who shared such a close fashion relationship with the visionary behind the festival, what it is that makes fashion so synonymous with Cotton Fest.
Because the festival was actually started around this community of kids who love cotton, who love fashion. So there would be no Cotton Fest if there wasn't the love for fashion. So Riky wanted to put together a festival where kids who really, really love fashion and use fashion as a self, a form of expression to come together and just like party. So it is about the look. It is about what you're wearing. It is about representation. It is about local brands. It is also about representing your hood, where you come from. We want to be able to take one look at you and be like, okay, shout out K1, we see you, represent, you know. So fashion is actually the reason Cotton Fest happened.
Cotton Fest is the only place you can actually really be yourself. It's like every single day we pressure, like, you have to live with school standards, whatever the case is. It's like, but every single time you come to Cotton Fest, it's the one and only time you can come through and really be appreciated for being different. You know what I mean? So everybody's coming through with their own individual combos and in different ways. You're like, hey man, that combo's actually too much. Actually, you pieced it together nicely, yeah. So it's like, you can't do that in like in a school environment, you can't do that in a work environment, and sometimes even in the playground. But when you're at Cotton Fest, you're allowed to be yourself. So that's like, I think that's the best thing about it.
First of all, we go to a lot of shows, but not a lot of shows you come to and everybody's kind of like decked out, swagged out. So one thing that stands out, besides the good music, is the swag.
So I guess it's in the name, really. Cotton Fest is all about ukotini and using it to express yourself and rip your culture to the fullest. Two guys who fully understand that and are doing it in a new way are my boys, No Comply.
Let's talk about like the culture of Cotton Fest. The fact that you guys came to Cotton Fest and you're debuting this new moment, like you could have done it anywhere, but Cotton Fest is really the perfect place because it speaks to music, fashion, culture, and just love for the game. So talk to me about where you at. Talk to me about what you're doing, and talk to me about why Cotton Fest was a perfect moment for you guys to do this.
Well, just the way you described it, it's about the entire culture as a whole, you know. We saw people skateboarding out there, you know, we saw people playing basketball out there. There's some fashion showcases, obviously. That's what the whole event is about, right? Cotton, right? So, I mean, we bought our 1,000-thread cotton towels.
That's it.
No Comply.
No Comply.
So there was no better
off
place,
the books.
Actually. Nothing actually made more sense than actually showing up full force.
Full force indeed, Pa. While fashion and swag may come naturally to a lot of us, we all understood that this year we had to go a little bit harder to celebrate the legendary Riky Rick, who sadly lost his life just a few months before the festival.
I
This was actually the first time the entire industry was getting together after his funeral, so it was important for everyone to put their best foot forward and show out for a really special friend that we all loved and respected dearly. And everyone pulled up, even the legendary mugs.
So tell me about Riky, a man. You obviously know him very, very well from a different perspective. You guys shared a really cool relationship, also from way, way back. Like, you know about Summer before Riky Rick even. So,
Riky's my brother, man. Like, yeah, man. That's why his passing, like, really hit hard. But today we're here to celebrate the man and, like, look at his work. And he created a monster. That's just a testament of his character, of, like, who he was. He was a monster inside. His ideas, he made sure they flourish. We've known Summer for, even back then, he used to actually incline us to, like, make different stuff, you know, push us and stuff, you know. So Summer, man, I always miss you, my guy.
Riky is many things. I mean, like, and it shows in how, in the outpouring of love for him. It's like he can comfortably sit in a fashion space. He can comfortably sit amongst rappers. He can comfortably sit in the new era of music. That's like, what is that sound, right? And like he and what I heard from him was this incredible catalog artist, like a guy who can make 20 albums of beautiful soul music. You know what I mean? That's what I heard from Riky, and that's what I wanted to kind of show people, that he can make a hit song, but also can make that song about his dad that'll make you cry.
Yeah, I think it is definitely different. It's like I hate the word bittersweet, but it sometimes feels that way, because it's like celebrating and mourning at the same time. It's so it's odd. And I think that's the one thing that stood out for me about this whole experience. I think I've heard so many tributes. Even in my own set, I did a tribute, you know.
The pioneer of it all is not here. And his whole legacy was about the culture and the put on. Yeah, it's just really important for young people to really feel like what you manifest can come to fruition.
I met him at Sports Inn. I was working at Sports Inn as a producer. And then, like, from there, we made a song. We actually had a song together. And like, we were just postponing and dropping it, but like, it really like inspired me a lot, because like, Young Intervenes are like, is how I like, I've imagined like to be like, as like an artist. So like, who inspired cool, like music, the driven, the way I understand how he came, like, who inspired cool, I don't want to lie.
I'm actually happy because his legacy is alive, and I can literally feel it in the room, I can feel it in the space, and I'm so glad that Cotton Fest is carrying on. So, you know, there's no tears over here. We're happy. We're celebrating his life, his legacy, and it's amazing.
Rest in peace. Thank you for everything you've done for the country, for the industry. I hope you rest well.
Riky really, really had a good place in his heart for you, man. But I hate to break it to you, but he loved us all. But
he really did.
How crazy is it that Riky Rick had time for so many people?
It's actually insane, because when I see like the impact that he had on so many people, it's like, where do you get that time, bro? Like, you must be legendary as heck to do that, you know? So I'm just glad that we could all come together and celebrate him, you know?
For real, man, for real.
Yo, I just loved him, how he loved everybody, you know, how every time I was down, he just always come at the right time. And it's like, yo, keep going, let's operate. I just love that he was always like an older brother. You know, so I wish there can be somebody like him, and I'm still looking. I hope there's gonna be some. But it was like, oh, don't worry, you need to do what I've been doing. Yeah, so don't be like, yo, shout out to me. You need to do what I've been doing. So it's all up to you, Benny. It's all up to us to do what he's been doing.
I feel like I could ask you, but you guys are literally gonna say the same thing, right?
He stole my answer.
Like, Riky just had so many time for so many people. He was such an amazing person. You guys are amazing people. My outfit is amazing. And I love you guys all. To Riky! Cheers!
Cotton Fest is all about celebrating how different we all are. But one thing we all have in common is how much we all love and miss our friend Riky Rick. and just how proud we are of the legacy he's built. A legacy that may just look like another party or festival to some people, but to others, it's a dream come true.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, one of the most anticipated performances of the night is just about to happen. Kotini is just about to go on stage, but before he goes, I want to just talk to a few of his dancers, see how they're feeling. My brother, hey, how are you?
I'm good, and you?
I'm good, bro. Oh, you're a dancer, right?
Yes, sir.
What's it like to be performing at Cotton Fest with Kotini?
By the way, this is my first time here. This has always been like the biggest dream of my whole life. And to be here, it's like just a whole different experience, and it's amazing.
I love that. What can we expect from you guys tonight?
What do you mean? It's Stitch Gang. We're going in.
We're going in. Like fog. Yeah. Pull up in a beam. Too much too clean and taller. Aye. Don't foster. Serious and other. A big time player. Crip too big and ganja. I went. What's it like having that Riky Rick spotlight? What does it do for a young artist?
Changes your life. That's the easiest way to say it. I wouldn't be here if you didn't take a chance on me, you know? And just eternally grateful for, you know, everything, you know. Yeah. I can start like fog.
Pull up in a beam. Too much to clean and tall. As for my first Kotini Fest, 2019, where it all began, I performed on the main stage in an outfit styled by Don Design. Fur coats inspired by Riky's King Kotini music video. After my performance, I actually had the pleasure of watching Riky's performance standing right next to a 16-year-old Uncle Vinny. Little did I know what he'd grow to become, but it was absolutely iconic to say the very least.
There's 2019 over there, 2020 over there, but now it's 2022 and it's Miss Cosmo! You have been doing this for such a long time.
Yeah.
You have played so many events and so many festivals just like this. Yes. From the first Kotini Fest to 2022.
Yes.
What's it like to still be here though?
To still be in the game or to still be at Kotini Fest?
Both.
Because now the kids call me Auntie Cosmo.
Yeah, I'm Auntie.
And I'm stressed about being an auntie.
I love being an auntie.
Because I've always been the youngest in the class. And now I'm like one of the old ones. And it's stressing me.
No, it's okay, friend. You hasn't. Sikhulile. We've earned our stripes. It's okay.
Out here. At the end of the day, I'm still looking not a day over 21.
Oh! It's Miss Cosmo.
I'm just saying.
Okay, no, but let's be serious, friend.
Okay,
let's be serious.
Okay.
Just as one of the most respected voices in South African hip-hop culture, talk to me a little bit about Kotini Fest and why it's so important that we have events just like this.
It's obviously important for hip-hop, it's important for music, it's important for the kids because they get a platform, they get a space for people to see them. Sometimes they just send their music, but nobody knows who they are. And because they've got stages like the stage and the Jägermeister stage, it's really awesome for them to get that opportunity for other people to experience their music.
For sure.
So growing the culture, growing the kids, giving them a space to grow themselves, and also just for like fun, man. Like, do you know how fun it's been like being here?
So lucky.
Like, we don't want to be inside anymore because we outside.
We outside.
Kotini Fest is such a cool event, and like, it's like when you perform here, yeah, there's always someone new to like love you, like know your music. So it's crazy because like, I know Wuthi Lapana, good crowd. When I was performing today, half of those people don't know me, but they were vibing. So it helps a lot. Like, it helps an artist a lot because you get to like reach an audience and like as an artist. Yeah.
So tell me about how Kotini Fest actually revolutionized culture, because it gave a stage to everybody.
You know what? When I came up, I like little history lesson. Do me in the volume. We were performing in jazz clubs, where after the jazz musician perform, we come with our little band and we perform rap music. So, and then even when I traveled overseas, it was like, okay, it's us, and then it's Angelique Kidjo, and then so I kind of know.
That's a flex.
I kind of know the world to be like varied like that, you know. So when he can, and I know it's so crazy. Kotini Fest is like, it's like him manifested into a thing. You know what I mean? It's all of him is here. All of him is right here, bro.
Let me tell you what it is. It's Kotini's never have died.
Eish.
They're multiplying.
Eish. Eish.
Let's actually leave it right there. Eish. I love you, Stogie.
Love you.
You're a freaking legend, man.
I love you.
Love you.
Dirty T, Jikey me.
That isn't the first time my mind would be blown at the festival. Matter of fact, even after the event has ended, the event lives on online and my mind continues to be blown, mainly because of the amazing work of photographers and videographers who become the visual mouthpiece for the event. Shooters like Minnie, Cedric from Everyday People Stories, Stefan Obi from Set Life, Kaya Bengu, TK, and even OGs like The Real Click Clack are just some of the names behind the amazing visuals you see online. Not only were they hand chosen by Riky to shoot performances, but they're also responsible for capturing Kotini, arguably one of the most important jobs on the day. And these guys are good. So good that even if you weren't there, their images make you feel like you were. One such shooter is Siyanda, a young photographer starting to make a name for himself on the streets and in the scene. He's currently finishing off high school at National School of Arts, but when he's not in class, he's capturing and learning lessons from some of the biggest names in the industry.
Tell me what it's like for you being a young street photographer at Cotton Fest.
It's very unexpected because you never know what you can see and the type of people that you see. And like you can see one good person right now, but in the next 10 minutes you'll never see them again. So it's really like, yo, yeah.
You really got to be on it, right? Okay, cool. Any tips to anybody who's like watching this and they're like, oh my gosh, I love photography. I want to do that. I want to get to Cotton Fest. What are some tips that you'd give? Like, do you need a flash? Do you need to just have a quick shutter? Like, what are practical tips that you could give to somebody watching this?
Just explore. Try everything that you can do. Just, yeah, try everything and see what works best for you.
Also, last question, who is your favorite South African photographer?
Me.
It's the confidence for me, and that's exactly what Riky wanted, man. Not just to believe in one another, but for us to believe in ourselves too. And no one knew this more than his little brother Temba, who hit the stage in an explosive way as part of an epic tribute performance to Bozonke.
Temba! Are you joking me?
Yeah.
Listen, there's so many things I want to ask you and we're going to get to it, but please, we have to start with last night because that was probably one of the most iconic moments in like SA hip-hop culture and not even just at Cotton Fest. But it must have been very special for you as Riky's little brother. Can you tell me about what it was like in that moment?
You know, I wish I could, but you know, in that moment, like I blacked out. Like I really wasn't seeing anything and I think I was having an out-of-body experience. I was being controlled by something else.
I think you were like in the spirit of Bozonke, for real.
For real.
Because you were carrying it, the spirit, everything was crazy, man. But it wasn't just about your performance. You've been involved in this festival, putting it together from the very beginning till this moment right now. Take me behind the scenes. What is it actually like putting together an event like Cotton Fest?
It is a headache. It is a headache Monday to Friday, 24/7. But, you know, luckily enough, we had Riky who saw it through. He actually laid out everything for us. And then all we had to do was just put the final touches on it. It was really so well planned out, like to the T. It's from this book that was laid here.
Right?
You know how he was. He was a perfectionist like that.
So many small details. For sure, man. I really love that. And shout out to the team, man. You guys really came together. The family came together. Auntie P, Mal, Mark. There's so many people. Talk to me about the team and the role that everybody plays here.
Well, we've got the Beanstalk team who did the structure and did all that stuff, this beautiful setup, they did all of that. And then obviously you've got the family, the team KMO, Bigzin, B, and myself helping out wherever I can. And that's us with the artists and the and you know, getting the energy together and getting the right people in the right places, you know. So it was a big production, it was a big pull from many different parties involved to put it together, but it came together well.
Teamwork definitely does make the dream work. And let's talk about the dream, man, because you obviously were with Riky when he came up with this idea. He had the vision and he even said, shout out to Temba, told me I got it. I still remember. So when you think about the initial vision of Cotton Fest and you see it living out today without Riky being here, do you think that we're doing him proud right now?
I think he's smiling down on us right now. I think we did it really well, the way he wanted to be done, you know?
Knowing Riky myself, I know he'd really be proud. Proud of how we all came together. Proud of how bright we are all shining. And even more proud of just how far we've come. Someone who knows all about that is the ghost, Lama Ghost. Okay, Malum Cool Cat.
Like, you were one of the architects and pioneers of this culture, you know? Yeah. You, Riky Rick, Boys and Bucks, the whole thing. You already know the story because you wrote the book.
What's it like for you to be standing here in this moment in 2022?
It's really surreal. Like, when you think about it, obviously, like, things that we went through, like, in the industry, and also just, like, personally, it's crazy. Like, I always appreciate every moment. Like, tonight I brought my eldest son and my fiance, because of, like, I don't take these things for granted anymore, you know?
Yeah. And let's talk about doing it for the family, man, because Cotton Fest really is a family. And I feel like from the very beginning of your career, that's exactly what it's been about. Just a short message to the kids about the importance and power of family, love, connectivity, unity, because I feel like that's what this is all about.
I think the simplest way is, if you've got an idea back home there, share it with your family, share it with your mom. The more people are praying around the idea, the better it's, you know, that's how you're gonna achieve it. You know what I mean? Like, even if it's like friends or uncle or the one uncle that listens, just like tell somebody out of your circle, you know?
I love that, man. I haven't seen you perform in a minute, bro. What is OK Maloom Cool Cat in 2022 looking like? I gotta know.
It's crazy. I really wanted to do a lot of tracks today, but obviously because of time constraints. So we're going to have to keep it short. We're going to do all the hits, basically. And then we got a special thing, though. I've got The Brother Moves On. So that's going to be crazy. I've never really played with a live band, so it's going
to
be crazy.
I can't wait to see you, Malume. God bless you, brother. I love you so much.
There's so much more I wish I could say and show you. But the truth is, you've really got to see it for yourself. Feel the energy and be part of the movement. So next time you hear that Cotton Fest is going down, make sure you get a ticket, get swagged out, and pull up. I do hope you've enjoyed some of the insights and essence to this amazing festival brought to you by me, your girl Moozlie. And I hope you never ever forget that cotton eaters never die. They multiply. And RIP Riky Rick. We will love and miss you forever. Summertime when the heat is on, cooler bag and the drinks are strong. Bulla boot with the speakers on, get down when the beat is on. And we say la 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 la.